we saw Reese Taylor in the cast? Do you have any idea what he did or how long it's going to be?
Just got a little hand issue, so I think he's going to be all right.
Okay. Yeah. Coach, a weekend of practice here. Everything's going to start and stop with the defensive line. How are you guys looking?
Improved. You know, I think, and again, I think we all were anticipating that just with these young defensive linemen from the springtime and the improvement that they make. I'm telling you, sometimes the biggest jump you see in a player is when they go from their freshman year where they redshirt to now all of a sudden they go from the springtime where they're actually getting their first real reps, and then they come back in the summertime. Some of those young players are really stepping up right now. That's exciting to see.
Who, I guess, are you looking to? I know it's a little bit by committee on that line. Coach Hagan likes to rotate a lot of guys, but who do you think are the guys that maybe you feel like you're going to want to lean on the most?
Well, I mean, Jerome Johnson's a great football player, you know what I mean? And he's got experience and all those things. I think, you know, he probably, in terms of the experience, the savviness, the physicality, you know, that's a guy that probably needs to take the most snaps in that room. I think we're all on the same page about that. You know, Juan Harris is just a different force in there, you know what I mean, because of how big he is and he can't be moved. And then, you know, I mean, you got a number of guys that, I mean, we really are. We're a D-line by committee. You know, we believe in that. That's our, regardless of our personnel, we're gonna rotate guys and keep them fresh. And I think what's nice is these young guys are put us in position to where you don't feel hamstringed, I mean, either physically or schematically in doing that.
Last year you played Cam Jones. Spring kind of moving around. How's he looking at Stinger, linebacker, so far this camp?
Very fast, you know what I mean? Very aggressive. He's just naturally a violent player, you know what I mean? So regardless of where you put him, he has a knack to find the ball. And when he shows up, he, you know, he's got an attitude, you know what I mean? So that Cam Jones is a football player, period, right? My job as the coordinator, right, and our job as the defensive staff is to take a dynamic football player and create different ways to get him close to the ball. So he will play Stinger. He's going to do some other things as well. And then even in that, we're going to find creative ways to get him in one-on-one matchups. He's special.
Concurrent to that, Mike is a guy who played a lot last season. We've seen him kind of running with that first team defense some here in the fall. Just how much have you seen him grow from maybe last year as a freshman?
Mike McFadden is a really good football player as well. In fact, there were plays that he made out on the field last year. I'm not sure he knew what the defensive call was, but he made the play. So a heck of a job there by him. Now he knows what to do. He knows where to put his eyes. And when you take an athlete like that that's instinctive, and now he's starting to figure out what to do, his production is going through the roof, as I'm sure you guys can see.
Who are some of the younger guys are stepping up maybe that have surprised you?
I tell you what, the young freshman, Josh Sanguinetti, he is so ball savvy. He's got great quicks, all those things. Those young inside defensive linemen, C.J. Person, Bo Robbins is playing inside and outside. Jeremy Passmore is playing inside and outside. Bo Robbins on the outside. And then C.O. Nofo, all right, he's – I'm telling you, those young defensive linemen are going to be special.
Obviously, it's your first fall camp as just defensive coordinator. I mean, has it been an all-in adjustment, or do you feel pretty prepared coming out in the spring?
Well, first as defense coordinator here, you know what I mean? So this is certainly, I think, because of the relationship that Tom and I have, and because this will be my fifth year as coordinating in the last six, certainly this is my comfort zone, is being the coordinator. And just, you know, I love building a culture of defense. I think our scheme is great. I think we're ahead of the game right now of where the game is going and where it has been. But at the same time, the building of culture to get players to execute at a high level and care more about themselves than they do, or excuse me, care more about each other than they do themselves, that's what's fun about this time of year.